Hello, it's me again. I'm Nafed. In this video, we will talk about templates. So in the previous video, we have talked about the switch template. But in this video specifically, we're going to talk about the variables and templates inside the template group. So we would like to look at how to download a template in a JSON format, add variables to the template, upload back template back to the group. So the variables would be effective. And then we will test the template, the impact of the change of the variables. Let's have a look. So now we have the switch template installed, or we created the switch template. And we have seen the variables, and we could change the value for the switch or some parameters in the variables listed here. This is online variable changing. So if I need to change the IP, then the hostname, whatever, these are the default variables that were generated by the system. So now what if I need to add another variable? What if I need to look at the switch? Because if you look at the template file, and in the template file here, you can clearly see that there are some parameters that are fixed, like, you know, interface, no power, this, like VLANs, for example. VLAN 10 is fixed. VLAN 11 is fixed. What if I have multiple switches? They have different conditions, different requirements, different VLANs. I might want to go back and see, okay, these VLANs need to be variables. So when I have multiple switches in the same group that template applies to them, then we should set variable values rather than fixed values. So anything common that needs to be configured, like uplink VLANs, it depends on the location, we'll make that variable. So what we're going to do now, we're going to change the VLAN 10, VLAN 11, VLAN 201, VLAN 221, and we will make them variables. Now we'll have a look at that. To do this, there's something called variables file. And in the variables file, you can download as a CSV, it's comma separated value, or JSON format. I prefer JSON format. So we can download this one. So in here, you can see a list of variables that are used or can be used or by default used inside the template file. We would like to create multiple variables in here. So we're going to create one for the client VLAN, one for the management or for uplink VLAN, and we're going to create another one for the other VLAN. I'm going to show you. You have to follow strict format exactly, as you can see it here. So you're going to go exactly what you see. So this is should start with underscore sys underscore and between double quotations, and then the variable is what value you would like to have it for. So I'm going to create first of all client VLAN. Again, client VLAN is your choice, whatever you like. The key point is to have sys underscore sys, yeah. And then obviously we're going to follow the same for that specific switch, for this switch, that with this serial number, the client VLAN will be, in this case, 11. So in the file, you have to have a comma after the statement, and the last statement, you don't have a comma after it, indicating this is the last statement in this JSON formatted file. So that's a variable file. We added four different variables. And rather than the switch template using a fixed value, we will replace them with a variable file. I'll show you what I mean by this. So if you go back to the switch template, I'd like to copy this template to make it easy to edit. So now we have VLANs 11.131. I'll leave it as is. We need it as is. VLAN 10, VLAN 11, 201, 2221. I'm going to take the value for these. So rather than, so I'm going to say, copy this, come here. We're going to use VLAN rather than the value, the absolute value. We're going to use the variable here. And to be able to use a variable, basically, we're gonna go and say percentage sign, then the variable itself, and then percentage sign as a delimiter. So these are the delimiters, and here we are able to use the variable file as is. Okay, so we will leave this as is, and in the name we will use the variable value. So we're going to use that value to compensate for the variable file. And then we'll move on the same. It's going to be applicable to the other ones. So for VLAN 10, we're going to go for the management. So we're going to copy the whole lot. Come here. Again, we're going to do the same. So VLAN percentage. And then we're going to use the same here. And we'll continue with the rest. Now we have the four of them as we wanted, so we're gonna copy this one, select all, copy, and we go back and insert it into the variable file itself. So we're gonna just eliminate the old one, and we're gonna paste the new one. So now the new variable, the new template using the new variables is inserted. We're gonna save it. So what we need now is to upload the new variable file to update the variables here. So upload, and we need to save the variables file, of course. So we've got to save this one. Let's save it first. And we have saved it. Now we go back and we will upload that variable now. That variable's file. So we're gonna go. It was in the download, I believe, and it was this one. Better practice is to just rename it to make sure that you got, it says upload successfully. If that doesn't reflect here, we can refresh the page. Now we're gonna see the new variables and the value for that switch. So this is the switch serial number. You notice that this has entries for different variables. AP10, AP8, we should see the other variables. AP client VLAN as well as gateway, the other one management VLAN. So 10, 11, 201, 2021. Now that is now reflected inside the variable itself, the template file. And we're gonna see that in the template file, we are using them as a variable rather than fixed value. So here we created, and now we can see show variables list inside the template file. These are the variables used inside the template file. So we're gonna close this one. We need to look, make sure that configuration audit doesn't generate an error. Otherwise, they will have a problem. There are some problems here. It says in here VLAN. Actually, the name should be just the name, because otherwise the name will be compensated with the an integer that is incorrect. So we're gonna just put the names as names rather than just variables. So we're gonna just remove this. And we go the same for the client. So basically, wherever it is replaced, the name will be always client VLAN. That's your aim, actually. So client VLAN, and then here management VLAN, AP10 management VLAN, and then the gateway management VLAN. So this is the way it should go. And now we copy that, we highlight all. We will copy this, and we come here. Delete all, and then we insert this one. So we're gonna save. Now we're gonna check. So that's been saved now. and then we will go in the configuration audit. Any issues here, we're going to refresh if, just to update this. So we have no issues, zero issues, everything in sync. If you look at the variables file that we have uploaded, these are the variables available. Now let's look at the switch and verify the values that exist on the switch is what we expect. There will be no change on this switch at all. So if you click, on the switch that we are talking about, show VLANs, you see the same VLANs, no difference, that even updated with the values. I'm going to just fix this, change the percentage. So we're going to look at this now, show VLANs, we're going to see the VLANs, and the one we have described are the correct one. In this video, we have covered the areas of how to download the template, how to add variables to the template, how to upload it back again, and how to test. Thank you very much for watching the video, and I will see you in future videos.